Okay,
first off, it's amazing to be here with such fantastic people. Being a part of this from day one has truly been an amazing journey. I think I've learned a lot about myself through this journey to realize that I don't always have to know all the answers. And if you surround yourself with good people and you continuously learn from good people, you can actually rise with people that are wanting to see you be better, if that makes any sense at all. And during this journey, I have not recruited the most amount of people. I have not been the fittest. I have not known the most about nutrition. I have not known a whole lot about the rock. And my teammates would attest to that. But yet, they've been able to rally with me, behind me, and allow me to do what I can do to try to support them. And it's been an amazing journey, and it's been a lot of fun. So for those that are sitting there thinking that it might be impossible, I'm here to tell you that it is very possible. If a schmuck like myself can get up here and do this kind of thing, anybody can do it. And that's not being facetious about it. It's like, seriously, like, you can do it. It's very, very real, very possible. The other part is, you just don't stop. Like, where you are right now, don't stop. It doesn't matter. If you pause, it's okay. If you need to take a little time out, a little grace, but in the race, it's okay. But just don't stop. That's the difference, I think, that I've seen, is that we continue to keep going forward, and it's been amazing. The recognition that Darlene has been able, and Jason and the rest of our team have been able to do for the rest of the team, that's huge. Every victory that all of you have, that's amazing. And I always have to end it going back to my wife. I was telling Darlene earlier that the coolest part about this whole process is being able to see that her name is alongside my name. Because she gets to be recognized, because she actually has to sacrifice a lot of things like time or my attention when we are building or doing other things. So I just want to say thank you to you, thank you to everybody else, and I know that this room, because our team is dominating, we're going to continue to keep going and pushing, and we're going to see a lot more Blue Jackets in the very near future.
Yeah. I just want to say real quick, last night I said it at the VIP dinner. It's not really about hitting the rank PD, I'm more excited about the person I was able to become during the process. I remember about 2.5 years ago, maybe, it was 2015. I remember having a conversation with Kenan Burton. He told me straight up and said, "Hey, bro, you have to get better." So I looked at him and said, "What did you say? Like, what do you mean?" So he told me, "You got to get better." And what he was telling me was I had to become better as a leader. So at that time, I looked at it and I could either, got mad at him or got offended. I said, okay, what does it mean for me to get better? So I had to analyze myself. I had to look at what I was doing personally. I was a great personal recruiter, but as far as a leader, I wasn't really growing in the standpoint of how to lead a team, how to guide a team. So one thing I started doing was personal development. One thing I looked at was the life of Jesus Christ and what he did. He showed us ultimate humility, but he also knew who he was as a person. So can you imagine being around somebody who came up to you and said, "I am the bread of life"? Looking at him, who's this guy? It's only made you get to the Father but through me. So what I thought about it was, okay, how can I relate that to me? So relating to y'all is you have to know who you are. Alright? So when you know who you are, also at the same time, you show humility. So when you know who you are, you're able to defer to the next person. You're able to serve those that come on your team. So it's not about you. So now if you hold on to ego, when it's about you, you have someone that made you better than you. I consider, I tell Keenan all the time, say you're better than me in this business. You know, the skill set that he portrays, things that he does, he's better than me. So I'm able to defer to him at a lot of times because business helps me grow. And I introduced him to the business, but I know who I am as a person. Okay, so it doesn't bother me to be able to defer to someone. Jessica doesn't love. I told her when I first met her, I said, "You're better than me in this business." I told her straight up, whatever. The skill set you possess, you're better than me in this business. Same thing. Christine, you're better than me. Jen Thompson, everyone, whoever, y'all better than me. That's like, because when you take the attitude and that approach, you're able to help and serve the people. All right? Now, what I mean by better than them is that I see potential in them. I see them, what they can do as far as what I was able to accomplish. They can far more exceed that. Okay? So that's what I definitely mean by being better. Not saying that they are better. I don't want you taking the wrong context. Some people may take it in the wrong context, but you can kind of follow me what I'm trying to explain to you as far as that. So that's the biggest thing I try to, my heart is to recognize who you are tonight as a person. Right? And then be willing to serve others. Teams don't have ulterior motives. Really care about those other people's success. You know, really care about them growing as people. And then go out and have a strong wife. My wife is strong. I have several wives. I have my boys in the back. You know, I want to be able to leave a legacy for them. I have my beautiful wife. That's my strongest wife. I always wanted to be able to provide for her in a way that she never had to worry about anything. I always wanted to be her to where she could have and do whatever it is she pleases. That's my motivation factor. That's my why. That's what drives me. That's what motivates me every single day to never stop going, never stop being consistent, never stop leaving, never stop trying to become better. So I encourage you to find those three things. Know who you are. Right? Be willing to serve. Be willing to go out there and help your team. Help them and have genuine interest in them actually succeeding. And then having a strong why. Let that motivate you. Let that drive you. You don't need anything else. If you have your why, let that be your motivation. So I encourage you. Next revolution, I want to see each and every one of you be at the highest rank. Be at your best potential. We have everything in place. There's no other guessing. We have a simple format that we can follow. Our simple plan that we can follow. Let's go out there, let's change the world. It's our time right now. I want you to believe, unwavering belief, that nobody can tell you that their product is better than ours. No one can come up to me and tell me they have something better. No one can come up to me and tell me that they have a better opportunity than this you have right now. You have to believe it. You have to believe that God gave you this opportunity right now. He put you in the room with these people right now. You have to believe that and don't let it change you. And I see this opportunity, I believe it. This is my opportunity. This is the field that I was going to use now. I was hoping, I was praying. It was nice, I cried. God, please send me something. I'm telling you, I wasn't just put here to be average. I know it's great things I can do. Please send me something. And when he sent me out, he like, I went in full head of steam, and everybody that come in contact with me, I'm trying to change their life. I hope you take the same approach. We have the opportunity to be blessed. Let's live life to the fullest. So we only get one life. And once it's done, it's done. So,
amen.
Go out there and kill it, man.
Let's go.